tell you of some of our first things that we did, and that we have plowed the way, trailblazed and things. And this is my little sister here. That'd be fine. Don't you cry.
Let me explain. TD was the first person scheduled. When we made a presentation at C.N. Jenkins, and Lillian was there, so we invited Lillian to come, and then there were some other nurses, so we invited some more, so that maybe some more coming in. I just wanted to help you out there.
Thank you. That's great.
It's her program.
Well, we were, since this was, you know, the historical data, I integrated public health nursing here in Charlotte Mecklenburg, and to talk about the incident of history and how we integrated the public health nursing department here. A little bit about myself. I went to school at Lincoln Hospital School of Nursing in Durham, North Carolina, affiliated with the University of North Carolina, you know, in Durham, and one of the heaviest and most, but that was, at, you know, the time when we were really segregated, and we were over at Lincoln Hospital, and we had to go through an oral presentation from the professors from Duke University, and we had to stand up and do everything to them orally. And that was something. We had to pull that old skeleton out of that closet, name every bone in the body. It was tough. It was a challenge. And tell the articulation where you gave injections, where you did this. It was something. And that was left there and went to Howard University at Fremont Hospital to study pediatrics. We left, came back to Durham to complete, you know, graduating there, and after that, after graduation, I went to the University of Chapel Hill to study public health nursing. And then I studied gerontology at Livingston and urban studies at J.C. Smith again. When I left West Charlotte in 1944, I had to go to Johnson C. Smith because I wasn't old enough to go in nursing. I stayed there almost 9 months and then booted on up to Lincoln. Signed in for a U.S. cadet nurse at that time. I have some books and things out there where I thought I was the cutest thing when I enrolled. That was in 1944. And that picture is in that book I want y'all to see.
You're still cute.
But thank you. But I wanted to list some of the first things that that we did, and they're out there on that table. I have a park here in Charlotte that's named after me. The picture is out there in one of those books. I established the Women Hall of Fame. It's about 14 years old. These are women that have been inducted into the Women Hall of Fame. Mm-hmm. This program, Martha, been inducted. This program has gone worldwide. It's in the library and the archives at the state level. We have one of the honorees that is writing a book on the women that have been inducted into the Women Hall of Fame, and that will be in the Library of Congress.
That's Carlina, yeah. Carlina is writing a book, Carlina and Dale
Smith. Yeah, okay. And then I established 3 scholarships, and I'm a Baptist, y'all. I'm a Baptist. And these 3 scholarships is Presbyterian, all of them. If you that was something else, but they were, you know, you include, I include everybody. I learned that, you know, in nursing. And there was, I can't read my own writing. Oh, there is a marker in front of the Panther Stadium that we put there commemorating the Good Samaritan Hospital. Also in Pearl Street Park, there is a monument that we put there through Park and Rec commemorating the first black park here. We try to establish things that have been commemorated by African Americans here in our city and county. A little bit about integrating public health nursing here, and I will entertain any letters. That was a challenge. It was really a challenge. Because during the tour of duty that we were totally segregated, and I had to integrate, I received the area where the Ku Klux Klan had the most power. That was out in the Jackson Homes. And I had to go to the beer pub to find out where they stayed, because all of the addresses had been removed. Because when they were told that we were integrating, they moved the addresses. So I always had to don my whole uniform, the cap, the bag, and everything. And invariably, when I walked in the beer pub to find out where this family lived, he would invariably say, "That's a white family. And what a nigger like you want with them." Mm-hmm. So I had to say, "They are sick and they need me." And then going into some of the homes, there were Confederate flags hanging from the ceiling to the floor. We had to wade through them to get to my patients. And I love my patients. I love people. Nothing can stop me from rendering nothing that I can heal anyone. And I thank God for that. And she would be there, or he would be there, they would have a knife or gun and say, "You better not hurt me." You know, but thank God again, because in the very end, that went on for a year. We did a pilot study program for a year. And then after going to the pub for so many times, they would repeat that. And my families began to love me and accept me, and I didn't have to go back to the pub no more. Isn't God great? They would say, "Oh, I'll tell you where they stay." So that's where I would go. And that was a real accomplishment in learning that and accepting that. And then when we finished that year of challenges, they were calling into my office saying, "Don't send them white nurses no more, send us." You know, because they were. And invariably, when we first started out, when you would go into the homes, they would say to me, "My floor need mop and empty the garbage and do all these other things." And I would invariably say, "Someone else will come and do that. I am your nurse to take care of you." But they, you know, accepted that, and we got along fine. In the meantime, at my administration at the health department had told me, "If you want integration, you is going to have to sell yourself." And that's what we did. It was two of us that did the pilot program. My senior nurse was Minnie Grimm, and Minnie, you know, helped me a lot, a great deal. And that was one of the highlights of public health nursing to me. After I finished that year, it was a whole lot of other stuff in between there. And after I finished that year, I was sent to Southeast Charlotte. That was worse. I won't even tell you about it.
Yeah, tell us.
That, well, I had clients there, and when I would go knock on the door, several of them would be, the men would be nude. And I said, that don't excite me. I do that all the time. That did not worth my patience.
All right.
And that's what I was care for. And I was also at Camp Butner, you know, taking care of soldiers coming in from World War II and some other challenges that we faced. This was the essence of, and I also had a family and two little boys and a husband. And I carried all that stuff home with me at night because of my patience and the love. Nobody could change that. We had been solely indoctrinated and cared for. And I thank God to this day, I nursed 45 years, and I never gave a wrong medication nor a wrong treatment. I did 14 years in the operating room. I did, I think, about 6 years on the maternity ward delivering the babies. I had two sets of triplets, I don't know how many twins and how many single births, but that's what we did. With that, I'm going to turn it over to my little sister.